Hello friends, I am Dr. Manju Sharma and today I would like to make an estimate of a beautiful poem written by K.K.N. Daruwala and which is entitled The Ghagra in Spate. Ghagra is a river and spate means anger. So generally when we talk about rivers, we call them lifelines. They are the natural lifelines that traverse a land and scatter life all over. It has been always the rivers that became the cause of settlements, that cause of civilizations to get established. किंतु ये कविता कुछ खास है. इसके अंदर केकी दारूवाला ने एक नदी के क्रोध को दर्शाया है. वो जो जीवनदायिनी है कभी रुष्ट होकर जीवन ले भी सकती है. तो एक तरीके से ये एक अनऑर्थोडॉक्स तरीका है किसी भी नदी के बारे में कुछ कहे जाने के लिए. एंड केकी दारूवाला टेक्स डिलाइट इन गिविंग टू अस एवरी माइन्यूट डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस रिवर द घाघरा गोइंग इन टू एंगर. द रिवर दैट हैज बीन लाइंग स्टिल, द रिवर दैट हैज फेड द पैडी फील्ड्स, द राइस फील्ड्स. One day all of a sudden decide to become angry. And rivers generally get flooded either largely during rains and sometimes when the water in the dams has gone above the mark of safety, on a danger mark, and when the water is released. So we will try to see how this officer from the Police Department of India turns poetic. The beauty of this poem is, and this poem is particularly a very largely remembered poems from among those written by Keki Daruwala, because we can plainly see that this river which is going into anger has turned a police person's heart into that of a poet. How beautifully does he suggest and has an eye for details, has an eye for the gradual change of this in the face of this river. So, and for this and for other writings, K.K. Daruwala was also awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in 1984. So we begin with the poem, because I and as all the teachers in English and all the students in English should believe that the estimate of a poet can best be made by making an estimate of his writing. So I begin. And every year the Ghagra changes course, turning over and over in her sleep. So the imagery here is that of a sleeping power. She has been sleeping, this river has been sleeping through the year. And the poem begins with the word and, without giving what has been the expression earlier. The poet simply begins the poem with the and. So this is rather to give you a continuum of the thought that rivers are living. Rivers have moods like all the elements of nature have, and that since man is also integral to nature, so as he changes moods, as he swings from one state of mind, one state of existence to the other, so also does this river every year. This is a recurrent phenomena. When there are rains, the Ghagra changes course. It just takes another way. It turns over and over in her sleep. So, in the bottom, in the lower layers of this river, it should be a deep one. In the deep side of it, should there be some kind of turmoil. Ye nadi neend mein karvate le rahi hai. Aur phir jaag jayegi. She will awake, not as a peaceful maid, but as an angry living being. So, you see, I would request you to kindly look into the expressions that the poet has said, because this is a descriptive poem. It describes the river Ghagra in the spate, in anger. So just focus upon the words. He begins by saying that it has been the sleep time, the remaining times of the year when it doesn't rain. It was simply rolling over. It was only taking turns. And one afternoon, she is a grey smudge. Smudge is a bleak, drawing. So, afternoon, it appears grey. So, when a river, instead of blue or green, when it turns grey, and grey is the color of destruction, is the color of death. So, she signifies, people may not take note of it. Log jyadatar avoid karte hain, lekin prakriti apne agaman ka, apne parivartan ki suchna hamesha deti hai. So in the afternoon, she is a grey smudge exploring a grey canvas. The repetition of the word grey is anchoring the idea of the impending danger, of the impending havoc. तो ऐसा लगता है कि एक scratches हैं, हल्के से कोई shades लगे हुए grey color के. So in the afternoon she is grey. When dusk reaches her, dusk is when the sun is about to set. When dusk reaches her through an overhang of cloud, she is over stewed coffee. So she becomes coffee color. From the grey, she takes another color. So please see the harmonizing time of the day and the color of the river. How she spells out the changing time. How she reflects the shade of the day, shade of the time. She is overstewed, too much stewed, too much, very dark it becomes. At night, she is a red wheel across the spine of the land. And then the poet gives the color of this river. She is a red wheel. Wheel is when someone hits the other, and the mark of the hit comes up, that embossed structure. So the river swells, and what color it looks like? It looks red. Now red, from the gray
to the coffee color, to the red. She is like a red wheel, एक जख्म जो उभर जाता है उसके जैसे, across the spine of the land. और ज़मीन कैसी हो जाती है, वो भी एक जीवित प्राणी है. The earth again is, you know, spine is the, you all know that the backbone has got the structure, the ribbed structure. So that kind of structure, it appears and it is red all over. The river spreads itself out, as does, as do the bones in the spine. Driving at dusk, you wouldn't know there is a flood on. The landscape is so superbly equipoised. So during the dusk, जो इसके पहले का समय था, you wouldn't even know that the flood is on. On is in the parenthesis, sorry, in the inward, within the quotes. So in the afternoon, when it was like coffee color, you wouldn't even know that it is going to turn red and bring out death. I'm sorry. The landscape is so superbly equipoised, equipoised, balanced, in a complete control of itself. It appears that the river is not going to do any harm. So I end here and we'll continue. This is only to sum up that the poet begins by suggesting that this spate, this anger of the river, is a recurrent feature. Every year this happens. And how does this happen? It changes course. The river seems to take the adjoining part under its cover, as though she had been turning over and over. And then he delights, Daruwala delights in giving to us the description, the every details, that in the afternoon she is grey and in the dusk she becomes an overstewed coffee, and at night she actually becomes like a wound. And in fact, you know, when you look at it at night, you would hardly believe that this would be the case. Some 1 hour earlier at the dusk, that the flood was about to come over. We'll continue. Thank you.